See, you might have heard like somewhere in your geography or anywhere, you might have studied about the water boundaries of India. Yeah? Like see, coastals ela mana kanipistarante. If this is the line from 0 to 12 nautical miles, I am speaking about the waters here, okay na? From 0 to 12 nautical miles. ఇక్కడ వరకు ఏదైతే వాటర్ ఉంటుందో దాన్ని మనం ఏమంటామంటే టెరిటోరియల్ వాటర్స్ అంటాం. ఏమంటాం? టెరిటోరియల్ వాటర్స్. క్లియర్? ఫ్రమ్ 0 to 24 nautical miles ద జోన్ ఇస్ నోన్ యాజ్ పర్స్యూట్ జోన్. ఏమంటామా? పర్స్యూట్ జోన్. క్లియర్? అండ్ ఫ్రమ్ 0 to 200 nautical miles వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇస్ ద జోన్ దట్ ఈస్ నోన్ యాజ్ ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ ఎకనామిక్ జోన్. ఏమంటామని? ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ ఎకనామిక్ జోన్. క్లియర్? దర్ ఇస్ 12 వరకు ఏమంటాం? టెరిటోరియల్ వాటర్. 24 పర్స్యూట్ జోన్ అండ్ 200 ఎక్స్క్లూజివ్ ఎకనామిక్ జోన్. మీనింగ్ దేర్ బై ట్రై టు అండర్స్టాండ్. సపోజ్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ పర్సన్ హూ ఇస్ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్ ఇండోనేషియా, ఇండోనేషియా ఆర్ ఎనీ అదర్ స్టేట్ ఇట్స్ ఇస్ కమింగ్ ఫ్రమ్, దెన్ హీస్ ట్రావెలింగ్ టువర్డ్స్ ఇండియా ఇన్ అ షిప్. Then don't you think so, first of all, you will be experiencing 200 nautical mile, exclusive economic zone, which means that he can see the companies of India, like Reliance, like ONGC, so on and so forth. That is, the exploration till 200 nautical mile, the minerals, the resources, the fishes, everything will be belonging to the companies of India. But to remember, the foreign companies can also extract the resources in 200 nautical miles as such. That is, if they have a good tie-ups between each other, they can go for extraction or by a foreign country also. After this, they will be coming to 24 nautical mile. So, no, there is a pursuit zone. Whenever they come to pursuit zone, they can see the Indian Navy or Indian naval officers in the pursuit zone. That is, you can see some ships in the Indian pursuit zone altogether. After that, they will be experiencing the 12 nautical mile. So, no, when they come to 12 nautical mile, they can here see the national flag of India, which means that the parliament will be having the power over the complete jurisdiction till 12 nautical mile. 12 nautical mile varako, parliament will be having the power. 24 varako, Indian Navy. 200 varako, Indian companies altogether. The point is coming very, very clear. And beyond 200 nautical mile, everything is known as international water. Yamatadane? International water. Similarly, you just connected where the China will be having a sea called South China Sea. Did that happen?
No, yes, sir.
So, South China Sea, the claim of China will also be till how many miles? 200 nautical miles. Yes or no? This is the international standard fix. So China will also be having a claim till 200 nautical miles. But what China have done is, beyond 200 nautical miles, they have occupied additional 9 nautical miles. And they have renamed a new title for the occupied territory known as 9 dotted line or 9 dotted channel. Clear all of you? That is a new territory, a new occupancy that is made by China. So, which is against the international standard, yes or no? Because international fix kitna ki, international only 200 nautical mile. But they have occupied beyond 200 nautical mile, that is about to 9 nautical mile, and this has been opposed in the international community. At the same time, try to understand one thing. In Sri Lanka, there is an island known as Kachatibu Island. You know what I mean? Kachatibu Island is located in Sri Lanka, which is a very, very important island, mineral rich island. Everything is rich, that is, the sea resources are abundant in this island. Try to understand. Kachatibu Island is geographically located in Sri Lanka. But Kachatibu Island, since it is very rich in minerals, fishes, prawns, etc., this island has to be occupied by Indians and also by Sri Lankan fishermen. Now, India and Sri Lanka are trying to occupy this island and they are fighting, which is resulting into a conflict called fisherman conflict between India and Sri Lanka that we will talk right now. Clear? So, the Supreme Court of India, after a petition filed by Jayalalitha way back in 2012, Supreme Court of India have given a judgment, have given a verdict saying that this island will be utilized in a year, first 6 months by Indian fishermen and the other 6 months by Sri Lankan fishermen. Clear all of you? There is a judgment given by Supreme Court of India, which is a very impartial judgment, which is a very genuine judgment given by Indian Supreme Court. But what happens is, In the time period of Indian fishermen, Sri Lankans are coming there. In the time period of Sri Lankan fishermen, Indians are going there. So if they see some Indians, they're assassinating, they're killing them. At the same time, if Sri Lankans are seen in India, they are also killing them. So it results into a fisherman conflict. Now, China, what it commented is, see, Kachatilu Island is beyond India, beyond Kanyakumari, so no? So when it is beyond Kanyakumari, don't you think everything is a part of Indian Ocean? Yes or no? What China said after this conflict is, see Mr. India, if it is named Indian Ocean, it does not mean it only belongs to India. Clear all of you? Then if it is Indian Ocean, then it means it is only the ocean of India. China has commented against India. Then India replied, okay, we accept. We accept your statement. See Mr. China, if it is named South China Sea, it does not mean it belongs to China. Clear? You take back your claim first and then later on you comment on us. It was again a water conflict arise between India and China. Though we do not have any water boundaries, still we will be fighting for boundaries, water boundaries, because we are connecting with Sri Lanka and they are connecting with some other or some of our friends like Philippines, Vietnam, all those. The point is coming very clear, the issue of South China Sea.